morning, students. Today we will talk about IUPAC nomenclature of branch in hydrocarbons. In my previous lecture, I've explained to you about the straight chain hydrocarbon and branch chain hydrocarbon. So, what are straight chain hydrocarbons and branch chain hydrocarbons? It's very simple. The hydrocarbons in which 3 degree and 4 degree carbon atoms are absent, or the hydrocarbons which contains 1 degree and 2 degree carbon atoms are called straight chain hydrocarbons. Then what are branch chain hydrocarbons? Branch chain hydrocarbons are the hydrocarbons in which 3 degree and 4 degree carbon atoms are there. Or we can say at least 1 3 degree and 4 degree carbon atoms are there. So let me explain this with the help of an example. CH3, CH2, CH2 and CH3 is the base of butane. Carbon atom is attached with one more carbon atom. A carbon atom is forming bond with one more carbon atom, so here it is treated as 1 degree carbon atom or primary carbon atom. Carbon forming bond with one more carbon, so it is also treated as 1 degree carbon atom or primary carbon atom. Carbon forming bonds with two more carbon atom, carbon bond with carbon on right hand side, carbon bond with carbon on left hand side. So this carbon is forming bond with two more carbon atom, so this carbon is treated as 2 degree carbon, and this carbon is also treated as 2 degree carbon. So from this example we can say that in this case 3 degree and 4 degree carbon atoms are absent, or this hydrocarbons contain only 1 degree and 2 degree carbon atom, so it is an example of straight chain hydrocarbon. Now let us make a change. Replace 1H from the non-terminal carbon atom or from the secondary carbon atom by a methyl group, that is CH3, then degree of this carbon atom will be changed, although this carbon is 1 degree carbon because it is forming bond with one carbon atom, but this carbon atom is forming bond with three more carbon atom, that is carbon first, carbon second and carbon number third, so it is a 3 degree carbon. So in this hydrocarbon we have 1 3 degree carbon atom present. So this is the case of branch chain hydrocarbon. So again, the hydrocarbons in which at least 1 3 degree or 4 degree carbon atoms are present are called branch chain hydrocarbon. So whenever branch chain hydrocarbons are given, then how we will name them? For their IUPAC nomenclature, we have to take care of three rules. And the three rules are longest chain rule, priority chain rule, and lowest sum rule. Whenever branch chain hydrocarbons are provided, then we have to take care of three rules at the same time. And the three rules are longest chain rule, priority chain rule, and lowest sum rule. Now, what is longest chain rule? To explain rule number first, that is longest chain rule, let us write one scripture. longest chain. You have provided one branch in hydrocarbon. Now, according to this rule, what we have to do? We have to select carbon chain which contains maximum number of carbon atoms. According to this rule, we have to select a carbon chain which contains maximum number of carbon atoms, which is called longest chain or which is called parent chain. So, let us check the longest chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If we start our counting from this end to that end, the hydrocarbons contain 5 carbon atoms. From here, 1, 2, 3, 4. It contains 4 carbon atoms. One more possibility. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I select this chain of the carbon atom, then this chain contains 6 carbon atom, which is maximum for the given branch chain hydrocarbon. So this chain of carbon atom will be called as longest chain, or it is called as parent chain. It contains 6 carbon atom. Now the remaining part here, CH3, is the remaining part here. So this remaining part is called side chain or alkyl substituent. So here, this is parent chain, or this is main chain. And this part is side chain, or this is called alkyl substituent. Now, about the nomenclature. Always remember one thing. Whenever branch chain hydrocarbons are provided, then first we will go for the naming of side chain or for the naming of alkyl substituent, then we will move to parent chain. So here, as a side chain, we have CH3 group, that is called methyl group. Remember, we have to specify the position of alkyl group here, or we have to specify the position of side chain or the alkyl substituent. While assigning position to side chain or alkyl substituent, we have to assign lowest number to the side chain or to the alkyl substituent. So if we start our counting from this end, 1, 2, 3, 4, on carbon number 4 of the parent chain, we are having methyl group. Let us check from this end also. 1, 2, 3, on carbon number 3 of the parent chain, we have alkyl substituent or side chain of methyl group. So from this end, we are getting number 4. And from this end, we are getting number 3. Which is least? 3 is least? 3 is lowest. So we will start our numbering from this end. It will be number 1. It will be number 2. It will be number 3. It will be number 4. It will be number 5. And it will be number 6. So parent chain contains 6 carbon atoms. And as a side chain, as a alkyl substituent, we have branching of methyl group. So first, its position, then its name. After this, we have to go for parent chain. So on carbon number 3 of the parent chain, we have methyl group as a branching. So 3-methyl. It's all over about the side chain. Remaining part is the parent chain. Parent chain contains 6 carbon atoms. So here it is MCN. So this is longest chain rule. Now, rule number 2, that is priority chain rule. what is priority chain rule? Again, it's quite simple. If in a branch in hydrocarbon, more than one longest chain is possible, or more than one parent chain is possible, then the chain which contains maximum number of branching will be treated as the parent chain or the main chain. It will be clear by the help of example. CH3, CH2, CH, CH, CH3, CH3, CH2, and here CH3. Let us check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Chain of 5 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Chain of 5 carbon atoms. So, if we go for this chain, it contains 5 carbon atoms. If we go for this chain, then this also contains 5 carbon atoms. So, which chain will be selected as the parent chain? Again, see the example. If this chain is selected as the parent chain, then we have this group present as the side chain or as the branching. Only one branching is there on carbon number 3. 1, 2, 3. On third carbon, we have one branching. Or we have one side chain. Now, let us change the selection of chain. Now, I am selecting this chain as the longest chain. It also contains 5 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But if I select this chain as a parent chain, then I will get two branching. I will get two side chain, or I will get two alkyl substituent. First alkyl substituent is CH3 group, that is methyl group, and another alkyl substituent or side chain as a ethyl group. So this parent chain contains two side chain or two alkyl substituent. In the earlier case, we have 5 carbon atom and we have one side chain. But here again we have 5 carbon atom, but we have two side chain. So this chain will be selected as the parent chain. This is priority chain rule. Priority is given to this chain because it contains two alkyl substituent. So when more than one longest chain are possible, then parent chain will be the chain which contains maximum number of alkyl substituents. Now, the last rule, that is lowest sum rule. What is the rule? Let me write one example. CH3, CH, CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, CH2, and CH3. Let us select the parent chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the selection of the parent chain. Case of priority chain rule is not applicable. Let us move directly to lowest sum rule. Now, what we will do? We will assign numbers to the carbon atom of the parent chain so that we can decide the position of the alkyl substituent of the side chain. Now, if we start our counting from right hand side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then, first side chain or alkyl substituent is present on carbon number 3. So, 3 plus. Second side chain is present on carbon number 5. So it is 3 plus 5 equals to 8. Let us check from left hand side also. It is number 1. It is number 2. It is number 3. It is number 4. It is number 5. And it is number 6. First side chain on carbon number 2. Carbon number 2 plus carbon number 4. Carbon number 4. So total is 6. So according to lowest sum rule, numbering of carbon atom in the parent chain is done in such a way so that we get lowest sum for the position of the alkyl substituent or the side chain. 3 plus 5, 8, 2 plus 4. Sum of the position of the alkyl group. 6. 8 and 6. 6 is lowest. So, if we start our counting from right hand side, it is wrong. Correct summary is from left hand side. 2 plus 4 equals to 6 because it is giving lowest sum for the position of the alkyl substituent. Now, the nomenclature. First, about the position. First group is on carbon number 2. Second group is on carbon number 4. So, first group on carbon number 2, second group on carbon number 4. Between the position, always use comma. Now, because methyl group is repeated 2 times. So here we will use numerical prefix di. So it will be 2,4-dimethyl. It's all over about the side chain or the alkyl substituent or the branching. Remaining part is the parent chain which contains 6 carbon atoms. So it will be 2,4-dimethyl. It's all over about the rules for the branch chain hydrocarbons. In next lecture, we will continue with some more examples of branch chain hydrocarbons. Thank you.